Our next agenda item is the student member report.
Good evening. Happy BCPS Day. I hope everyone gets to enjoy the pictures of staff and students wearing blue across the county. And I hope everyone enjoyed their holidays. Since my last SMOD report on November 5th, students gathered on July 1st on our superintendent's first day to come together again on November 7th at the Superintendent Advisory Council to give the superintendent and staff students' perspectives. That same evening, the Anti-Bullying Task Force met and planned out the agenda for our upcoming meetings. On December 11th, I had the chance to spend the day with our transportation department to see the behind the scenes of all the hard work being done to make sure our buses are in the right condition, making sure buses get on time, and picking the safest and fastest routes for our students. This department is continuously working on improving for our students. The big topic of the night, our budget. As a student board member, I have to voice the concerns of students that I have heard since my term started. I hope we make sure our students have buildings and facilities that allow them to have proper learning environment and make sure this is for all our schools rather than a few, including making sure they have safe and proper transportation to and from schools, which requires us to support them. I hope we make sure we have well-educated and trained teachers, especially for our special education children, to make sure they are receiving the best instruction and support possible, which requires us to support them. I hope our programs like ESOL that are growing tremendously are given the support they need, which again requires us to support them. Unfortunately, I do not get the chance to vote on budget, but hope the students' interests are kept in mind during this process. This year, with the support of our IT team, Office of ELA, Social Studies, and BCPS-TV, 2020 will be the first year the process of the student member of the board will change. We will have everything online to provide the opportunity for all secondary students the opportunity to participate in this process. Candidates' speeches and question and answer will be posted online and be posted for students to review, and one day will be dedicated for students to vote. This makes the process fair and equitable, ensuring all students get the chance to vote for their representative. Just a reminder for those of you applying, consideration for SMOB, the deadline is tomorrow. Can't wait to read them. As always, students, feel free to reach out to me via social media or email, and keep inviting me to your schools and events. Thank you. Yeah.